day before.
What's up, Chicago? It's your man, Maze Jackson, getting ready for the Maze Jackson social media question of the week. That's right, live on WVON today. We are going to be talking about our congressmen. Should they sit out this election? And if they're sitting out the election, who's representing us? We're going to have a great show. Stay tuned. It's the Talk of Chicago, 1690 AM. It's your man, Maze Jackson. Now, as always, gotta say what's up to my main man, Tyler.
What is up, Mr. Jackson?
I'm great, man. Now, if you notice the smoothness of the glide of the camera, so now we're gonna go on over and talk to the lady herself. What's up? It's Sonya. She is getting ready with the magical fingers. I'm gonna head on into the studio, ladies.
With Doma T.
I will stop in with Doma T. As always, you know I gotta give my boy Doma T some love. Check it out, y'all. I'm working on my new camera.
Happening. The former Chicago police dispatch super is facing prison time for her role in a contraband smuggling scheme. We'll tell you more about that at 8:30. Traffic and weather on the way. It's 8 o'clock.
The U.S. bombs. Doma Tizzle in the building. What's up, man? How you
scared doing the mess out of me. I kept it together. I was like, what is this?
I'm sorry, man. I apologize, brother. What's hey, good, boy? Tell the people what's up, Doma Tizzle. You going tonight?
Man,
Chicago State?
I'm not. I can't make it tonight, actually, man.
Chicago State, man. That's the place to be. We got to find out about our legislative agenda, man. What's going on?
It's going to be good. I'm sure you're going to have us on Facebook Live.
I'll go on Facebook Live, so we'll be reporting live.
I'll be sneaking under the table where I'm at.
Hey, y'all, check. What you got going on, Doma T?
Man, I got to meet, man, with some folks about some things. Look,
he turned into the man. They got to take him up.
I got to meet with them people.
I heard that. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Maze Jackson, now I need y'all to take a moment. Share the broadcast. I'm about to go get us set up. Let's get cracking. Y'all ready? How y'all doing this morning? It's your man, Maze Jackson. All right, guys, give me a second. Work with us here. We are flipping our camera to now moving into tripod mode, seeing as I do not have any staff this morning. Hope everybody's doing well. Good morning. What's up, Chicago? It's your man, Maze Jackson. Everybody take a moment. Share the broadcast. If you could just take a moment, hit that button right there. Share the broadcast. I need your support. Looking forward to getting this show cracking today. Y'all ready? Who's out there with me? If you're out there with me, show me some love. What's going on?
Yeah, readings from above the continents and oceans around the globe. The World Meteorological Organization determined that the
all righty. It's your man Maze Jackson getting ready to go live right here on WVON. And I'm going to need you to take a moment, share the broadcast. Let's get ready. Let's get it cracking. Things up. What's up, Sad? What's up, Mob? How you feeling, bro? What's up to my beautiful, lovely wife, Commissioner Carrie Steele? What's up, Sad Brumley? What's up, Anthony Muhammad, all the way from Atlanta, from the A? I got to get a different chair. What's going on?
Maybe this year I'll stop calling me new guy Nick. Well, there are worse nicknames. I've worked there 6 years, and my name's Doug.
What is going on? Why do I feel so low today? All right. What's up, man? How's everybody doing? We are about to get it cracking, get it live. And I need y'all to take a moment. Do me a favor. Share the broadcast. We're going to get it. It's a day away from the Trump presidency. We got a lot to talk about. Man, I don't know how I feel about everybody sitting out of this election. What's going on? What y'all think?
Phone system. Make and receive business calls using our iPhone and
Android. All right, app. Let's go.
Get a new business number or keep your current one. Woo! Forward your calls to.
Yeah, I had a little hiccup this morning. Voicemail. Woke up and realized I did not have a tripod, didn't have my camera in my bag, had to stop by the office and it just threw my whole day off. But that's all right. We ready now. We rocking. System. You rocking with us? You out there? Let's see who's out there. First of all, let's go.
So we put Xfinity Internet up against
the... Arlene, thank you for joining us, and thank you for sharing the video. Let's see who are my sharers right now. So Arlene Jones, thank you for sharing. Sonia Escobese, what's up? Thank you for sharing. Michael Smith, Anthony Muhammad, and my beautiful and lovely wife, Commissioner Carrie Steele. Are y'all taking a moment to share the broadcast? Tell your neighbors, tell your friends, it's time to get on. Derek Bryant, you watching, not participating? Boy, where you at?
/challenge now.
Woo, y'all is hot already. And I'm ready to get it cracking. All right. What's up, Earl? How you feeling, man? I think we back next week, man. I was just been a little bit crazy, right?
Go to xfinity.com/challenge. Call 1-800-XFINITY or visit...
All right, let's see what we're working with right now. All right. So, Anthony Muhammad, Cedric Brumley, I want to thank y'all. Sonia Escobar, Cedric Brumley, let's see my shares. We've talked about that. Have you broadcast reach over there? Kristen Dumasani. I told you I love saying that name. What's up, Kristen? You better share that broadcast. I see you out there.
As I host America's Heroes Group.
Y'all, my coffee is kicking in. Something's been wrong with my Dunkin' Donuts lately. We got to figure that out. If you're out there, let me know you're out there. Give me some love. Say what's up. Give me a shout. You know what I'm saying? Hit the button. Reach over there, hit that button, share.
Where we speak truth to power.
Share.
Greetings, family. This is Celine Mwakio.
Y'all ready for the Maze Jackson social media question of the week? Y'all ready to get it cracking? Now, I don't see my
radio audience.
Sly, I was wondering where you was at, man. I was like, man, I need me some. Now, wouldn't it be great if my shows all had Appalachia water in there? How awesome would that be if I had a, you know what I'm saying? What's up? Thank you. Y'all, have y'all checked out the What's In It for the Black People Facebook page? Make sure you check that out, too. Dan Lee, what's up, man? Let me see. Have y'all taken a moment to share that broadcast? Share the broadcast. Share. Hit the button. Don't take it. It takes that long to share the broadcast. Wake them up. Now we got a lot to talk about. Donald Trump.
Traffic and weather. Now.
Tomorrow.
Supports backed up 111 to the Dan Ryan Expressway. On the Dan Ryan, we see delays from 95th. To the Chicago Skyway.
Okay.
From Garfield all the way to
Let's
the
get it cracking.
35 minutes, 95th to downtown. Lakeshore Drive.
I'm just saying, Sly, you should hit my line, bro. I should be drinking Appalachia. My joint should be cracking. What's up, ladies and gentlemen? There's your main man, Matt McGill, getting it in.
They're all traffic.
Polish, too.
I know. Any Eastern European.
What's up, y'all? Good morning. Hallelujah.
Family man wouldn't know anything about
see
that.
See Todd over there?
Oh, yeah.
We got Todd this morning. All right, y'all. We about to get it cracking. Last day. We got less than 28 hours.
Lord.
The clock is ticking.
Oh, Lord.
The clock is ticking, and black people are sick. What are we going to do? Sitting it out. I don't know. Good morning, Tennille.
Is that your sister?
That is my sister.
Tell her Todd says, hello, Tennille.
I think she can hear you.
Hello, Tennille.
Can y'all hear the radio?
I got the thing in the other room. Let me get it for you.
Huh?
Nothing. I got a thing for Chicago State.
Chicago State's tonight.
Basketball.
Basketball.
So guys, you still have time to check out the Christians. This highly produced play of 2017 is one of the top 10 produced plays of the theater season. And it's at Steppenwolf Theater, one of the top theater companies in the country. Quality all around this production. It made its premiere at the Steppenwolf. Now you can check it out. What are you going to be checking out? This incredible play about religion. Do you believe? Well, maybe you don't believe. Either way, according to the LA Times, this is a play that both believers and non-believers can embrace. New York Times calls it mesmerizing. You're just going to call it a great play, no doubt about it. Get out to the Steppenwolf Theater and check out The Christians. What do? They bring the environment of a megachurch to the stage. Also, they bring a choir live on stage under the musical direction of Jared Landon. You don't want to miss this. Intense conversation about religion, plus bringing some spirituality into the building. All of this going on at the Steppenwolf Theater, it's the Christians playing now through January 29th, guys. Easy Parker, they got a new cafe up there where you can get a snack and also a drink before the show and after the show. And of course, after the show, you have conversation to talk about what you just saw. Go to steppenwolf.org right now and put in the code WVON, and guess what? You get $20 off of your ticket. It's just like that. It's a hookup. It's a WVON hookup. So go to steppenwolf.org today. Buy your tickets for the Christians. All right. Phone lines are open at 591-1690. Maze Jackson in the house with Maze's social media question of the week. What's going on, Maze?
What's up, Matt? How are you? How are you feeling, man? You look like you might be depressed, man.
You look like you are going through
the Obama doldrums,
the
man.
The doldrums, brother. The blues.
Man.
I got a headache too. But that is
that don't have nothing to do. That don't have nothing to do with last night, does it?
No, a little bit.
Right.
A little bit.
But, so it seems like a lot of people are tying one on, Matt. Seems like a lot of people.
Well, you know what I think the reality of this Trump administration is, you know, as you see all the preparations for the inauguration and people start realizing, man, this is about to happen. Can you believe this? This is about to happen. And of course, the final days of President Obama really brings it, you know, to light for a lot of people, you know, that this is about that. We're about to have a new president and we're about to go back to feeling like we did when Ronald Reagan was president. So that's just the reality of it.
Man. Well, Matt, I think it's time to talk about it. You know, so we're going to talk about that in today's social media question of the week. So, Matt, I've maintained that while I have consistently maintained that President-elect Donald Trump has not attacked black people directly, it does seem as though racial tensions in Chicago specifically have increased. Whether it's the blackface pinata that we saw yesterday at El Jefe restaurant, the Chicago police counting the days until they can ignore the Department of Justice report, or even a police officer who decided he needed to use the N-word while calling 911. I think things are going to get worse before they get better. But in this environment, can the black community really afford to sit it out? Can we afford less representation? So I want to know, so today's social media question of the week is, should black congressmen sit out the inauguration or go and represent the black constituency regardless of their personal opinions and feelings? You see, while we've complained about Trump meeting with people like Steve Harvey and all these other celebrities, we've left him with limited options of people to meet with, right? Mm-hmm. So if the Black Caucus stands up and says, well, none of us believe that he's a legitimate president, and we're not gonna talk to him, then it puts us in a precarious position at a time when we need the most black representation to be vociferous and to be a presence, mm-hmm. right? To be like, you're not going to be able to ignore us and we're not going away. You know, I always think the best thing that ever happens is for when I want somebody to go away, is for them to decide to pick up their ball and leave. Mm-hmm. Because now, when you leave away, what happens, Matt? When you leave, then it's easy for me to ignore you. They left. So now I'm not going to offer you an invitation. Mm-hmm. Now I'm not going to say you're welcome at these events because you've already declared me illegitimate. So now what you're saying is, in one way, we don't want the president talking to Steve Harvey, et cetera, because Steve and all the celebrities caught a tremendous amount of backlash. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, all of the people that we've elected to represent us have chosen to sit it out and declare that this is illegitimate. So I want the WVON listening audience to give us a call, 773-591-1690, post to Facebook or tweet, but let us know, should our black congressmen sit out the inauguration or go and represent the black constituency regardless of our personal feelings? You know, Matt, they tell us to go vote, right?
Right.
But they're doing essentially, obviously this isn't a vote, but essentially they're doing the same thing that they're complaining about, which is this voter apathy. So I don't like the outcomes of what I've seen, so I'm just going to take my ball and run. I'm going to sit it out. What does that teach our next generation? So if you sat it out, Why shouldn't the young people who say they're not going to vote sit?
So, you know, like for me, there's a part of me that doesn't want to watch the inauguration, you know, be a part of it, right? So I've got to ask myself, what is that about? All right, that you don't want to watch it. So it's less about me being involved in the fight and more about me feeling a certain way about the hypocrisy of America, though. You know what I'm saying?
But isn't that the same hypocrisy we've lived through every day? Yeah. I mean, I feel like if you look back at the history, what Donald Trump did is the exact same thing that Ronald Reagan did. We're still here, man. Mm-hmm. And actually, you out of the Reaganomics is what birthed the Jay-Z's and the... I mean, what I'm saying is, Matt, is do we really... I'm listening to the calls, Matt. Are black people really that mad about this Donald Trump thing? I mean, I think we're sad about Obama, but I don't think that black people are all that bent out of shape. And I even think that we're not as mad as the Democratic Party needs us to be about Donald Trump getting elected, which is why they made John Lewis go take the bullets. Mm. John Lewis, we knew that Donald Trump was going to clap back. You knew, regardless of, and again, all it does is open up the ability for people who would not, you know what, they might have disrespected President Obama, but John Lewis is a congressional colleague, and I think that they've all given him a level of respect. A level of respect across all kind of genres and platforms. Mm-hmm. By marching him out there to declare the president illegitimate, it just opened up another opportunity for Trump to take shots at one of our icons.
Sure.
And it was also an attempt of the party to get black folks riled up, because right now, I don't see black folks all been out of shape. And most of the conversation has been around the Latino community. So I don't think that black folks are really still making a connection. And I think we got to address that.
So here's the question, though. What is our insult level, right? Because, like you said, during the campaign, Donald Trump talked about immigration for the most part. His target was the illegal Mexican. For the most part. That's how he kind of got fired up, middle America, these Rust Belt.
And black folks, too.
And black folks as well. He utilized that. There's no question about it. However, you know, Donald Trump insulting the African-American community was in his selection for attorney general. You see what I'm saying? So he didn't really mess with black people during the campaign or say anything out of pocket.
But wasn't Jeff Sessions elected? Wasn't he?
Yeah.
So was the insult level, did we really kick off? He was already in the highest, most exclusive club in the country.
Yeah, but
he was already.
He in Alabama now.
Oh, so where black folks are.
There are black folks in Alabama, but not as many as there are, obviously, white voting folks, or else a Jeff Sessions wouldn't be there. So I think Donald Trump has taken his swipes at black people in subtle ways. I'm going to put Jeff Sessions. I'm going to make this guy who is the polar opposite of Loretta Lynch, I'm going to make him the attorney general. Somebody who is going to try to undo anything that's not going to respect the accomplishments of this Justice Department in terms of doing investigations on police departments, consent decrees, and all of that. I'm going to bring the anti-consent decree guy in and see if we can undo any of these voting right things and da 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 da. That's the shot that he's taking at black people, and black people should be upset with that. Instead, you know, we're kind of like, well, we'll see what Trump does. When it's already like, well, he's already done a couple of things. He's already shown you disrespect by questioning your president's, you know, birth certificate. And then
Matt, I'm suggesting that
Klansman in as attorney general.
But are we not suggesting that Hillary Clinton didn't ask about his birth as well? What I'm suggesting is, Matt, again, I'm not going to have this fight about which white guy is the worst white guy.
Right?
Which are we complaining about racism in America?
Yes.
Okay, so guess what? We've been complaining about it since we got off the boat.
Right.
Now, did the black community ask the black legislators to sit it out, or did the Democratic Party ask them to sit it out? What I'm asking is, what did the black, what the people that are elected to represent us,
mm-hmm.
Did we ask them to sit out of this election? I am just concerned that as they take these stances, and I think we really need to get some new tactics, because I think they figured out boycotts and they figured out marches. Marches, just let it get cold. Mm-hmm. Boycotts, just wait. So can we do something different? Can we figure out what is our path forward without necessarily having to link ourselves to the complete drag down of the community? What's the black plan? Because I understand why they're sitting out from a party standpoint, but why is the Black Caucus sitting out on behalf of black people when black people need the most representation now?
All right, 591-1690. We got some phone calls. We'll get to them when we return. 818 on WVON. Domitic Pongo, traffic and weather. Coming up next.
Connect with Matt McGill. Call 773-591-1690. Make your opinion count. On the Talk of Chicago, 1690 WVON.
All we say to America is be true to what you said on paper.
As we celebrate the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., WVON presents King Transform.
All right, listen to this, man. All right, so if you are listening live, you're going to hear, check this out. This is our boy.
Today we pick up where we left off yesterday.
Hey, Perry.
Spoke David. Hi. Had reached. Hi, Matt. Hey, Mike.
What's going on, Perry's mom?
Access equal housing opportunities.
Where to go? Where to go? Where to go? Crazy. All right, listen to this.
However, Mark.
Black. I didn't know that.
You hear that?
Who's that?
Oh my God, George.
Hold on, here you go.
Is him talking to Method Man?
Hey, Method Man, this is Donald Trump. I'm in Palm Beach and we're all waiting for your album. Let's get going, man. Everybody's waiting for this album.
They would taunt and antagonize.
That's hilarious. That is hilarious.
But this check your email. You know, Georgia. I just sent you Donald Trump and Method Man.
You know they're gonna
die. Hit on his album. Listen to it. If it's good, we'll come back to it.
Were they right though?
You know, George and Barbara are gonna die
together. I think that this is all a ploy for them not to have, for none of the Bushes to have to come to.
I think W's still going.
I thought it was a whole ploy. I was like, boy, these white folks slick. They was like, have us all. Now the new thing is gonna be to die together with your love of your life after the Carrie Fisher publicity. All right, y'all. Y'all heard that video? Did y'all hear the Method Man? Method Man. And, does everybody remember that Method Man and Donald Trump was on the Method Man album?
Select varieties of signature.
Perry, we need some new tactics besides marching and boycotting.
Traffic and weather now.
Y'all, we need new tactics besides marching and boycotting, because I think the white folks have figured it out. Marching? So?
Brian, traffic's backed up from 95th to 87th Street. Also, heavy Garfield all the way to the burn. 35 minutes 95th to downtown. Meanwhile, with Stevenson's an hour long trip from 55 to Lakeshore Drive. Yeah. Traffic's a standstill from the Dan Ryan to Lakeshore.
So
and I can't be 25th to the burn.
He's the one that wrote that.
So,
yeah,
VON.
Is he here in Chicago?
Okay.
All right, y'all, what's up? How y'all feeling out there? Y'all take a moment. Share the broadcast. Share the broadcast. Let's see if we can get this to 50. Can y'all help me get the 50 today? Share the broadcast. Tell a friend, tell a neighbor. If everybody on the broadcast shares the broadcast, I bet we can get to 50 viewers today. I'm really trying to get to that number today. Help me out. Could y'all do that for me? We got to stop because we need some new tactics. We really do. I think they want to get him killed.
They charge us all kind of stuff.
I need y'all to take a moment, share the broadcast. Hi, Kristen Dumasani, share the broadcast. Mm-hmm.
No kid.
What's up, Michael Antonio?
Thanks. All right, guys, tune in Saturday afternoon, January 21st, 2 p.m. Chicago State women's basketball. The Fighting Cougars take on the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley. Pregame starts at 2 p.m. on the Talk of Chicago, 1690 a.m. WVON. You guys like the way I said Texas, Rio Grande Valley. That's coming up this Saturday at 2 p.m. Chicago State basketball on WVON. Chicago State in the news. No doubt about it, had with their new board members, and we had Paul Vallis on yesterday. Next week, though, I look to get some of the other new board members on as well to talk about the future of that university.
It's getting ready to get hot in Illinois, man. You know the governor hired Vince Bass as the top dog to do the outreach to the black community. So it's, you know, game is about to change. Did you notice the governor was on?
On what?
He spoke at the Push Breakfast.
Yeah, he came on with me Monday.
He actually got on the stage.
Yeah,
that was a first.
Governor Rowland.
Was on the stage at the Push Breakfast. It's getting ready to get cracking. Shout out to Vince Bass.
And governor's wife came on with me.
Yeah, I heard that. You had Chris Kennedy, too.
And Chris Kennedy came on.
You had it cracking, boy.
And J.B. Prisker was about to come on.
J.B. Prisker. Hey, man, somebody showed me a picture. Somebody said that if they ever make a movie about him, they should use Oliver Platt to be his lookalike.
He seemed like an interesting guy as well. So it is about to get interesting.
It's about to get hot in Illinois, boy.
824, Mace, repeat your question before I go to the phone call.
Should the black congressman sit out the inauguration or go and represent the black constituency regardless of their personal feelings? See, Matt, once again, I believe that the black congressmen are there to represent black people. And I think that by us not being in the backdrop and the photos, etc., it removes us from this point in history. Yes. And it makes it just that much easier for them to ignore us. Now, and again, who, moving forward, all they want to do is be able to push us in a corner and not be able to have to acknowledge the issues. We've been concerned and complained about the fact that we feel like we've not been represented properly. Now, black folk, we love President Obama. I said I wasn't going to say anything bad about him on his way out. But what we can say is that the black community does feel like they have been in some way shortchanged in the last 8 years. Got the symbolism, love all that, but we're talking about outcomes. And so now we're going into what could be potentially the most challenging time of our recent lives, and our elected officials have chosen to sit it out. What does that tell our young people? What does that tell America? The people that they are elected to represent will have no presence at the inauguration of the United States president.
Maybe that's just their protest. I'm not gonna participate in this charade that is the inauguration of this illegitimate president.
So when they say we don't participate...
I'll vote against him.
Right, but then when they just say, you know what, your office has been locked. Since you don't want to participate in government, I'm saying that we're at a very crucial time in our country's government, right? This thing could go either way. It could go to fascism. We could go to... There's a lot. And I just don't know if us sitting out and removing ourselves from any part of this process helps us in the long term. They don't want to be here. Send them over to the reservation, too. They did it to the Indians.
Let's go to the phone calls at 591-1690. And let's go to Tony. Tony, good morning. Welcome to WVON. Tony.
Tony.
Okay, we might have to come back to Tony.
Tony, are you there?
Tony's phone is having some... he got one bar, man. We'll he got one bar.
Arthur, good morning, Arthur. Welcome to WVON.
Hey, what's going on, Matt?
You, brother.
Hey, a couple quick points. First of all, if I don't like the headline, I don't have to show up. That's number one. So what May's talking about don't make any sense. This is all entertainment. It doesn't mean nothing. And the young people are already sitting on inauguration. They see a black person get inaugurated. Black people follow the election from the entire time Barack Obama announced it. So anything related to politics from that perspective, electoral talk college, you learn all of that when the president was there. And Maze, you all ask a question, and then you get on the radio and you talk about 30 minutes, and you don't give a chance for those you want the person to answer the question to talk. You got to let people call in and talk about it. That's number one. And number two, Maze, you talked about the president so bad. I don't know why you talking about it, because you the one wanting to talk. You want the same problems, because you talked about the president, the very person who let you get on the radio to support the president. So you should even be on the radio to talk about it. May God bless.
All right, Art, you gotta. All right, you did. Did you want to respond?
Nope.
All right, let's go to. Where is Tony? Tony, are you there? All right, I guess Tony's not there. Well, he's not there. All right, let's go to Pam. Pam, good morning. Welcome to WVON.
Hi, Matt. Hi, Maze.
Hey,
I'm
Pam.
Hear me. I'm sorry because I know I'm transitioning from outside too. The car. I just want to say, Matt, first, I'm looking forward to the interview with your cousin, and I'm glad you postponed it so we can really hear that story, and it won't be overshadowed.
Yeah.
Maze, here's the deal. Maze, it's an inaugural. It's not a legislative event. It's not a hearing. It's an inaugural. And I support Representative Lewis and any other representative who decides to sit it out because they feel that it is, he's an illegitimate president. Trump spent his whole, career, well, since Obama was in office, stating that Obama was an illegitimate president. So, at this point, I'm fine with that. As a matter of fact, one representative, she did a poll with her constituents, and they said 84% of them wanted her to do that. So I have no problem with them sitting it out. And Maze, it is a false equivalency when you equate this protest, and really what I call standing up to a bully, with young people wanting to vote or looking at this as an opportunity to use this as an excuse to back out. And lastly, I'm going to say this, Maze, you're a commentator on here, Maze, and that's an important position because you get to voice your opinion. I had one email exchange with you, Maze. And from that exchange, for me, I found you to be a little bit condescending and kind of mean-spirited. And I told you that in the email. So my concern for you, Maze, what is your agenda? Because I think you have an agenda that you are not fully disclosing to black people, black America, to here in Chicago. I know your problem with the Democratic Party, and I get it. But to tell me to go Republican, that's a non-problem.
No one told you to go Republican. You have not. First of all, I've never told anybody where to go. Well, let's be clear. Stop, Pam. You're hearing what you want. Now, first of all, let me back up because I sat back and I let you talk. I would say this. I would say that what I am trying to do is make us aware of the issues that are occurring so that we can address them. I'm not suggesting that anybody go Republican. I'm suggesting that there is no difference between, you're not going to convince me that one white guy that's trying to do me is better than the other white guy because of a D or an R. As it relates to my personal agenda, there's two things. One, to participate in the economic largesse that this country produces for the people that I see on a daily basis, one for myself and two for my community. And it's really that simple. And the other part is just to move our community forward. And let me say, the last part is to stop this groupthink that forces us to all feel like because someone has programmed us a certain way that we can't look and start to ask the questions. We get pushed when the choices are between bad and worse. We always feel like we got to make that choice. So I just feel like I want to present an alternate point of view. That's all.
All right, 8:31 on WVON, 591-1690. Time for Doma T. Pongo and WVON News coming up next.
Live from the WVON News.
Dang, this beat up, man. What they mad? Look, y'all, I know y'all mad. Obama about to be gone. Peace out. Y'all still ain't got nothing. Y'all still looking. Everybody mad.
Our news now. Here's what's
happening. But you know what? I like them.
Former Chicago police dispatch supervisor. I like them.
I'm trying to meet them like in person. But I really want
to
have a
county jail. Stephanie Lewis pleaded guilty yesterday to conspiracy to commit extortion. Prosecutors say she used police databases to obtain personal information on a
some kind of dinner or something with listeners. I actually want to do a dinner with my Facebook people that I always hear all the time that I know from Facebook and feel like I know them, but don't know him 100%, right? So I'm going to probably put something like that together too. But man, bro, it's like we got to just start asking questions. I feel like we were talking about this the other day.
Making these changes will not be easy. It will require tearing down a culture that within the department that has existed for decades, even generations.
I'm a disgruntled Democrat.
In a report, federal investigators said the Chicago police officers have committed numerous civil rights violations. Illinois Attorney General Lisa Madigan is suing the nation's largest student loan company for putting students in debt for the company they would not.
So it's not that, man, I have an issue with the fact that we don't participate equitably in the party that we keep afloat.
Alleging deceptive practices.
Oh my goodness. All right, who we got out there? First of all, have y'all shared the broadcast? I'm trying to get the fifth one.
Yeah.
On the subject of voter suppression, President Obama noted the reason people make it harder to vote.
The reason that we are the only country among advanced democracies that makes it harder to vote is
why y'all just get directly
back to Jim Crow.
Right.
And
he
says the whole idea of voter fraud is fake news. And he says after he and his family exit the White House this coming Friday, he plans to stay out of the spotlight.
Have y'all taken a moment to share the broadcast? What's up, y'all?
Hey, Tahani,
what's up?
So
we're going to have 5,000 National Guard.
Make sure that my wife.
You're going to have 5,000 National Guard protests. They're going to have law enforcement from all over the country at the inauguration.
They do that every year.
Not like this. Until daughter Sasha graduates. Never ever in the history of this country have you had that kind of president.
Wow. Now, not even with the black president?
So the National Lawyers Guild has announced that they are going to give free legal advice and represent legal.
Somebody is giving away free weed, too. Normal is giving away free weed.
Oh, yeah. I need to be there.
I wanted to go, but I'll, you know what?
I don't want to go.
I wanted to go, but I'm actually scared. I'm not scared, but nervous today. Because even if you win, I don't feel like you're going to be walking through a black dude. You walked through the wrong crowd.
I don't want to be around.
You saw that Bikers for Trump was mounting up to go? I was like, oh, Lord, no, I ain't going.
So I'm telling you, so you're going to see, you know, they have a lot of rules. You have to have special permits to protest. So the Lawyers Guild is going to be there because you've got people like the Bikers group that you're talking about. They're just going to be just fucking up black people just for the sake of fucking them up.
Man.
And protest. They are just going to.
Right, I'm going to say that from right here. I'm son of anarchy. I'm going to be right here. Jackson, right here watching from the safety of my home. Because I was just thinking, like, no, I actually wanted to go. You know what? I wanted to go just to cover it. Just to watch. You know, like, to the actual scene, the peaceful transition of power when it ain't really that peaceful.
It's not
going to be. You know, but I thought the same thing about Obama.
New York strip steaks,
I really do. I think that white folks at this thing. They're going to do it today. But they're going to be like, get ready. You're going back. Now, I think the difference is the people they're talking about you going back to, though, are not us.
Commute 95th to the Skyway. Travel time 35 minutes from 95th to downtown. We also see the
Booger Man.
First, he's got all interchange. Well, the Stevenson, watch out for planes between the Dan Ryan and Lakeshore Drive.
Man, milk is the worst thing for you to do. You know what? I used to have asthma. Like chronic asthma, like could not, like debilitating, like shut me down for 4 days, and my old man did not believe in asthma at the time. So he'd be like, it's no such, but you playing. But anyway, we went to an Indian doctor. Like my mom was like, you gotta do something. They tried everything. They took me to an Indian doctor. He took me off milk. I never had another asthma attack ever again. Because milk is all phlegm and mucus and all that stuff, and they done strained it up. That's why you have to take lactate. That's why I don't like nobody no ice cream around me.
Thank you.
for the show. Come on, we're trying to get the
picture. All right, it's 8:37 on WVON, guys. Get over to Dakota's today and tell them you want the WVON hookup. All right, don't tell them that because I haven't created the WVON hookup yet. Get over there, 107th and Western. Go right in. Tell them you want a pound of shrimp. You want to do the fried shrimp challenge that Matty Matt always talk about. 1 pound of fried shrimp. Go in the car and eat it in the parking lot. And you tell me that's not some of the best shrimp out there. There's no doubt about it. You will be satisfied. Get over there, 107th and Western. Enjoy the best seafood in town along with some of the best side orders. Homemade potato salad and coleslaw, just to name a few. Give them a call, 773-238-7071. Order in advance and your food is ready for you when you get there. I'm talking about Dakota's. You will be too. Dakota's provides Chicago the best seafood for over 60 years. It is time for Maze Jackson's social media question of the week. Maze, repeat the question. We got some phone calls we can dive into.
Should black congressmen sit out the inauguration or go to represent the black constituency, regardless of their personal opinions? Give us a call, 773-591-1690.
All right, so who do we got on the board? We got a couple of calls up here. Jimmy, who's next? I got Don, and I've got, let's go to Don. Don's been holding on the longest. Don, good morning. Welcome to WVON.
Good morning, guys. Thanks for taking my call.
Welcome, bro.
We took our eye off the ball again. John Lewis went to bed last night saying, thank Trump Almighty, because over the last week, sales of his book, written in 1998, went up 800,000%. He made more money in the last week than he's made in his entire life. The question now becomes, what does he do with it? Does this become a moment or a movement? Does he wallow in the money and say thank you and walk away? Or does he do something with it that he now has to, against Trump here and against what's going on? We're wallowing in symbolism again without realizing, you know, what's happening. So if he wants to do something, have an alternate, inauguration on tomorrow. Do something with it, and let's try to do something. I think Mays is right. Sitting on the sideline, has it worked for us before? Why would it work for us now?
Well, see, I think this about John Lewis. What you see, the protesting that you see by people not showing up for the inauguration is exactly that. That's what they know how to do, right? Protest. And do it in a demonstrative way. And that's what I think you're going to continue to see, John Lewis do.
But, Matt, I feel like that is the black way.
The
black way is to protest, to wait till it happens to you, and then then protest it happening or fold your arms, instead of saying, man, where is our path in this forward? Let's proactively work towards our plan. That's all I'm saying. I just don't know why we sit out a process that, man, obviously they didn't have the influence to whip up the votes that they needed completely. In the places that we do, we can't sit it out for the next 4 years.
See, what's going to be interesting is to see what leadership emerges out of the Black Caucus. Because you know Donald Trump is going to do this symbolic thing and meet with the Black Caucus, right? That's what he's about, these photo ops, symbolism, and stuff like that. So he's going to meet with the Black Caucus.
They're not going to meet with them, though, right? Remember, he's not a legitimate president. Remember, John Lewis said he can't come to Selma. The president of the United States can't come to Selma as part of the march.
He might reconsider that. Even Reverend Jackson said that when I had him on Monday.
But think about that. Right. I mean, I'm just suggesting that, guys, this is not the path forward for black folks. We lose in this.
Right. Let's go to Alfia. Alfia, good morning. Welcome to WVON.
Good morning, gentlemen. I absolutely agree with Maze 100%. And anybody that knows anything about politics knows that you have to be able to be at the table. If you're not at the table when the discussion is made, then how are you going to get anything done? In order to get people to understand your views and your positions, you have to be able to talk to them. If we've not learned anything from the president in these last few 8 years, is that when you disagree with someone, you go and talk to them. You don't just not ignore them. And I do agree with Mays, too. When you look at the photographs, our black congressmen need to be
at the table. They need to be in the photographs, and it's very easy to just put someone aside if they're not there. Blessings to you both, gentlemen, and have a nice day.
All right, thank you.
Alfie, let's go to Jimmy. Jimmy, good morning. Welcome to WVON.
Good morning, gentlemen. Thanks for taking my call. Maze, long time no see.
Long time.
How you doing? Listen, the question that you asked, number one, we need to ignore that inaugural. And the reason being we need to ignore it because, number one, it means that we accept his presidency. And we don't accept that. The problem going forward, what should happen is that our younger folks need to be involved in the process because the Black Caucus is pretty much working on their own and they're working for themselves because we haven't given them our voice as to why we disagree in numbers. And that's the problem. Even for myself, I just graduated college myself, and I talk to the young people. They have no clue about this process and what goes on. They don't even have an inkling idea about conservative values. But they're about to find out what's going on. And that's the biggest problem, that people need to be educated on the process instead of saying, number one, that we need to sit it out and things like that. We need to educate our young folks to get involved in the process so they know exactly what's about to come forward. They don't understand that. And I talk to them on a daily basis. And I think what you used to do back at Burnett's office and get involved in the young people, that needs to happen more. We got to get involved with our young people to make our Black Caucus represent us more. Because when you don't have a voice, they don't understand what's going on. They need to hear from the community. And that's not happening right now.
So can I just say, though, that if we don't, you know, my biggest concern about Black people declaring the process and declaring an illegitimate president that followed the rules, not the electoral colleges is part of the rules, right? So my concern is if President-elect Trump followed the rules and did what he was supposed to do along the lines of the Constitution, and then we say we're going to ignore that when it's our turn, right? Whether it's some constitutional issue and some white conservative says, I'm ignoring that. I don't agree with that. I don't agree. Even if you followed all the rules, then the next thing, we're on a slippery slope. Now what you're looking at is every Black elected official that white folks don't like getting elected, being thrown out because they just decided he was illegitimate, even though he followed the process. Guys, remember, this is going to be history, and think about what it looks like, not today, but 50 years from now, there's no Black faces in the inauguration. Hey, they can rewrite history off of this.
But the problem being is what you're saying is that the younger people, they don't understand what conservative values and things are all about. You could talk to your blue in the face about what we need to do and what the process needs to go forward, but until our younger folks understand the seriousness of the problem that's going on out there, we're going to be stuck with these same problems. And that's what's going on right now. And again, like I said before, you used to be out there. I know your thing used to do with the ring.
I'm still out there, bro. I'm still out there every day. On the front lines.
The problem is that we're not reaching them in the masses, and that's not happening. You have people that could care less about voting. You have people care less about what happened to Black people and what they did to have that right to vote. These younger folks don't care about that.
I think, you know, look, the reason why I call Donald Trump an illegitimate president is not because of the Electoral College popular vote debate. I do it because I think voter suppression played more of a role.
The U.S. Congress, the state legislature, all of the people that Black folks had the opportunity to vote for, put that in place. Donald Trump didn't do that. So I'm not defending Trump. Right. But what I'm saying is, here we are right now staring Jim Crow right in the face. If you look at all the states, they're all red except for the urban centers. Mm-hmm. They can pass pretty much anything that they want to, and we're saying sit it out, cross our arms, and fold our balls up. Fold our arms and go away when that really is not beneficial to us. What message, Kristen said it right, or Arlene said it right, what message does sitting out send the same young people that we want to participate in the process to?
847 on VON, 591-1690. Domity's got traffic and weather coming up next.
Connect with Matt McGill. Call
773. Y'all lost, man. I don't understand the whole thing. Like, we just got to get some new tactics because this boycott stuff, What does boycotting the inauguration do except wipe you from the hit? Think about the pictures of the inauguration, and they be like, black people didn't even have a place in Congress. They can just start slowly eliminating you. Do you want your legislator? I need three more people to watch this. Four more people. Can y'all give me 50? Can you knock on your next door neighbor? Can you just tell them right there? We have set a record number of comments. I need you to push that share button right there. Domitizi, come on. Do it right. Push the button. Share. Woo! All right, we hit it. All right, y'all. You are tuned in to the Talk of Chicago. It's the Maze Jackson Social Media Question of the Week on the Matt McGill Morning Show. Look at y'all. Look, there goes Sonya. Bring her coffee in. Y'all want to see?
Faculty and state-of-the-art facilities.
She got double coffee going. She
look like it's cold out there. Domitizzle.
Saturday night party right here on WVON 1690 AM. Our beer is always cold, our barbecue is always hot, and our blues are always real. For a red, white, and blue good time.
Right, I feel like, okay, who we got out there? Let me say what's up to all my people. First of all, shout out to everybody who gave us a share. Let's go through this real quick. Shannon Washington, thank you, and to the East Side Buddies. Julian Sample, Lorenz Gladney, Chris Ray, all the way from Florida, man, Miami. Man, we got to kick it soon. Otis Armstrong, Still Running Stovall, Eric Harton, John Rembert, Arlene Jones, Marcy Ordez, Felicia Muhammad, Erica Swain Farrell, Salim Muwakil, Salim! 582 Auto. Mike Woods. Geico agent. Michael Antoine Ralph Jr. Man, I got a lot of new people. Welcome. Still Running Stovall, Rhonda Lewis, John Rembert, Bob Israel, Antoinette Peterson, Sister Save-A-Lot, Tanil, what's up? Mark Armstrong, Ronald Albert Nethery, Sly Townsend, Peter Salter, Thimby all the way from Seattle, Kristen Dumasani, What's in It for the Black People. Have y'all checked out the What's in It for the Black People page? Check out the What's in It for the Black People page. Shout out to the True Squad on deck. Maze Jackson page, Arlene Jones, Sonia Escobese, Mike Smith, Anthony Muhammad all the way from Atlanta, and to my beautiful and lovely wife, Commissioner Carrie Steele. Now I need y'all, remember, I keep talking about all this black stuff. I'm going to need y'all to vote for Commissioner Carrie Steele, Democrat. Hey man, you know, that's why you know I got to love Democrats, my baby Democrat. I just want them to treat us all fairly, right? What's up, Erica?
All right, guys. Barry coming up at 9 o'clock. You don't want to miss that. Also, all month we are celebrating the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King. Listen for King Transformed, a chronological look at the final years of Dr. King's life and movement. Now through January 20th, weekdays on WVON. Also, Chicago State Women's Basketball Saturday, January 21st. At 2 p.m., the Fighting Cougars take on the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley.
Rio Grande! Pre-game
starts at 2 p.m.
Andale, riva, riva!
I hope they're playing down in Texas. I'm sure it's warmer down, even though it's going to be warm the next couple of days.
Man, I came outside. I don't even wear a coat. Man,
50 degrees.
Actually, I wore it because I thought it was kind of slick.
I think I saw we were getting up to 55, guys, on Saturday. I believe it is.
They canceled the ski jump. Hey, Matt, are you going to the
54.
Illinois Legislative Black Caucus update tonight at Chicago State?
Is that right? No,
I did not know about that. They're going to give us a legislative update, so we're going to find out what we can expect this year because we haven't had a budget for 2 years, so they're going to update us on the legislative agenda. I'm going to be broadcasting live from there, so you can get that on my Facebook page live.
What building is it going to be?
They're going to be in the library, I think on the library on the third floor. So, somebody send us a note, you know, where the Chicago State event is, but shout out to Larry Luster, Executive Director of the Illinois Legislative Black Caucus, bringing programming to us.
All right, we've got some phone calls at 591-1690. Let's go to Will. Will, good morning. Welcome to WVON.
Hi, good morning. I'm Art and I'm Maze. Look here, I want to support that brother Maze 100% all what he said as far as all of us getting all in an uproar about Donald Trump, one white man that's going to destroy the whole black nation. I thank you all for having that brother, because that brother is talking truth. And I also thank that brother for always raising the Honorable Louis Farrakhan name, because that brother knows that the minister been talking unity for over the past 40 years that he's been taking on to the messengers. To the messenger's whole program, and no one else would even mention the minister's name. And the minister is the one that you don't have no one to think but talk with Donald Trump. Let all those people that's running in his office and talking to him, why don't they direct the minister, direct Donald Trump to talk and meet with the minister? Because I think that's the only person that can talk straight to the Donald Trump and his administration to our problem. Thank you for listening, and thank you for taking my call. Peace, brother.
That would be interesting. Would Donald Trump take a meeting with the minister?
I bet he would.
That would be, knowing the way he likes to, master the media, that would be interesting to see if he would do that. Vanessa, good morning.
Good morning. I was wondering, why do black people have to be so forgiving? Because when Benjamin Netanyahu disagreed with the UN, you don't see him sitting around a campfire saying, "Kumbaya." No, he's going to build more settlements in the West Bank. He's going to do what he wants to do. White people created the Tea Party when Obama got into office because they thought he was an illegitimate president. They said he was born somewhere else, he's a Kenyan and whatever, and they created their own party because they hated him that much. But we always have to kiss the butt of people who kick us in the teeth. Yeah. Central Park 5, housing discrimination lawsuits, misogynistic views. This man is an idiot. I don't consider him illegitimate. He legitimately won the presidency. I consider him illegitimate because he's just an evil person who ran for office, not because he was going to help America, but because he was mad at people telling jokes about him as a White House press correspondent there. If he did it for his own ego. It had nothing to do with, "I'm going to help America."
Hey, sis, this is Mace. So I want to say this. I'm not suggesting that. First of all, I'm the king of "let us not dance when there is no music." Right? So it seems like there's so many times that black folks got to, particularly in that space, in the political space, have to dance and smile and cheese and pretend like it's a good thing. I'm not suggesting that they go to the inauguration and smile. I'm suggesting they could go to the inauguration and all wear black fist gloves and black power to the people, etc., and let the world know. But don't wipe us from the history.
Black Tea Party. Why can't we have our?
We can, but that doesn't change anything about the people that are. What the Tea Party did was elected people to go into Congress, not sit out of it.
Put our own people. It's like create a Emily's List for black people so they can, for the next elections, they can put people in for our own causes.
Your number
one. I don't
one,
understand why we have to be so nice to people who are not nice to us.
I wholeheartedly agree with you, sis. But again, the people that have been not nice to us here locally are not Republicans, just for the record. But I'm with you.
I know, but look at Bruce Rauner. Bruce Rauner says this is what he's going to do. He gets in there and he cuts the things he said he was going to do. And yet there were blacks who supported him. Now, where are those blacks now? What are they saying about what Bruce Rauner is doing? Why can't they,
I take that same thing, though. I would say that. Remember all the people that sat out?
Party and then try to get a budget. And
remember people were ticked off, though, with Pat Quinn, and they sat out? And then they got Bruce Rauner, right? So the last time we sat out, we got a situation that we are not happy with.
I don't understand what Pat Quinn did so horribly that we thought Bruce Rauner was the better alternative. I didn't think he was, but why did people think he was the better alternative? I don't understand.
All right, good call, Vanessa. I like your vigor and energy there. Let's go to Courtney. Courtney just called in. Hey, Courtney.
Good morning, Matt. Good morning, Max. This is your boomer.
Hey. Love it. Thank you.
And I agree with you, Max. I don't understand why would we want to not participate. And for you, Maddie Matt, I want you to man up and stop being sad every morning that I listen to you.
Can't help it.
What it is, Maddie Matt. You okay?
Okay, I can't take it.
And everybody's talking about how bad Barack was treated. I never saw him stand up for anything, not even himself.
I would dispute that. But,
of course you would. But But when this man asked him to prove his birth, couldn't he have said, I'm not going to prove anything. I am the president of the United States. That's all I wanted from Barack.
I would have
zapped all. Just stand up sometimes. So, Matt, I listen to you every morning. Tomorrow is the big day, I think.
I can't
have
take it.
Coffee. Get yourself together, man.
I can't take it.
What we going to do, cry tomorrow? We got to stand up.
Max, would you please help him, please?
I'm amazed.
No. Now, here's, Courtney, here's the deal. It's not about not accepting it. Oh, I accept that Donald Trump is the president. What I am going to do is to continue to remind people about the hypocrisy of this country that allows for con artists like Donald Trump to become president of the United States. If we accept this, then we accept anything. See,
isn't that essentially what we've been doing?
Well,
accepting anything?
No. Do you now? You might disagree. Let me ask you a question. Mm-hmm. You might not like Barack Obama. Hold on. Let me ask the question.
You like him. I like you. But I'm going to tell you what I did wrong. I voted for him because he was a black man, and I'm not ever going to do that again.
So you think Barack Obama...
He never made me feel like I was a black woman, Maddie. He never did.
Not even when Michelle danced?
What do you want him to do, though, Courtney? What could Barack Obama...
I want him to get on that truck. Get his stuff out the White House.
No. What did you want him to do as president of the United States to make you feel good as a black woman?
Well, I don't need him to make me feel good.
Well, what did you want? What did you
tell these people? No, everything isn't always all right.
See, that's the problem, though. We want that man up mentality, that American cowboy mentality, and we can't accept it when somebody the whole no drama Obama. See, that's what people wanted drama. They wanted him to represent drama, and he was not going to do that. And that's, see, people want him. They crossed the line in Syria. Send some troops over. He still got what he wanted, chemical weapons removed, without sending a single soul over there to die. That's what I'm saying. That's what you call intelligence and style. All right, we're out of here. Mays will be back at it tonight.
Peace.
Check him out tonight. Perry's coming up next. Guys, have a nice one. Back at it tomorrow morning on the dreadful inauguration day.
Yeah.
The talk of Chicago.
Hey, y'all, let me be clear. I'm not rooting for Donald Trump. I ain't all in fired up for him to be president. What I'm suggesting is we have to live in a world that we are, not the world that we have. We had 8 years. This reminds me of the time you go on vacation and you sat in your room and then you go do this and then go do that and on the day away, on the day you leave it, you drive past all the stuff you didn't do. That's what I feel like we have right here. But ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow earthquakes and we heavy will snow. Wake up.
Criticism is pouring in about
on
the
Saturday morning. We will wake up and there will be a new president. What are we gonna do? 30 people missing. They have to remember. We're gonna wake up on Saturday morning with a new president. Are we gonna bury our heads under the covers? Or are we gonna get up and we gonna do something? Ladies and gentlemen, you have been tuned into the top of Chicago, 1690 AM. It's your man Mays Jackson on the Matt McGill Morning Show every Thursday, 8 to 9, WVON 1690. Peace out. Now, finish this. Share this broadcast. Share the comments. Let's keep the conversation going. We need to let they watch it, so you got to tell them what you think. Peace out. What's up, Tahani? Shout out to my beautiful, lovely wife, Commissioner Carrie Steele. Black Chicago, they're going to try to make me pay for talking the truth. I need y'all to vote for my wife in 2018. Peace. Commissioner Carrie Steele, that is.